Our service, and we are going to begin by allowing the family to process in from the back door, and as they do so, we shall sing and we will also stand on our feet. But just a few preliminary announcements before we get there is that if we need to use the ladies or the gents, we can use this side door, exit 2, go down the stairs, and the bathrooms are around the back of this building. Please also watch your bags, because we know that though we have gathered as family and friends, some people may be here with other agendas. So please just take care of your belongings even as we gather, so that we don't have any incidents. So I'd like to invite us to rise to our feet. As the family walks in, and we shall sing, "When peace like a river attendeth my way, it is well with my soul."
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like seas billows roll, whatever my lot thou hast taught me to say,
for strength, we look to you for comfort, We look to you for hope in the midst of our tears. For you are our refuge and you are our peace and you are our strength in the storm. And so, Lord, even as we come this morning to celebrate the life of our dear sister, we ask that you would preside over this entire service, that you will comfort our souls even as we hear your word, as we pray together, as we hear, Jehovah God, the tributes that will be shared, that, Lord, you will speak your peace over our souls. And so, Father, we ask, may you have your way this morning. May your comfort rest upon each and every single person here. In Jesus' name, we believe and pray. Amen. 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 Welcome once again to Nairobi Baptist Church. And as we begin this morning, we are going to sing one hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. For those who have programs, it's on the last page, the second last page of your programs. So you can turn there. What a friend we have in Jesus. Lord, we thank you that we can come to you in prayer. When we are heavy laden and heavy burdened, we can turn to you in prayer. In Jesus' name, we believe and pray. Amen. I'd like to invite us to take our seats this morning as we continue with the rest of our service. I'm going to invite those who are doing our scripture reading this morning. We have Mina and Cherono. Please come up for the Bible reading. I think both of you can come up. And Mina will be reading from Psalm 23.
I'll read the first reading, Psalms 23, verse 1 to 6. If you're there, I shall begin. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod, your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. The last and final verse. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. That is the word of the Lord.
Amen. And our second reading will come from John chapter 11, verse 1 to 11.
John chapter 11, verse 1 to 11 says, "Now a man named Lazarus was sick. He was from Bethany, the village of Mary and her sister Martha. This Mary, whose brother Lazarus now lay sick, was the same one who poured perfume on the Lord and wiped his feet with her hair. So the sisters sent word to Jesus, 'Lord, the one you love is sick.' When he heard this, Jesus said, 'This sickness will not end in death. No, it is for God's glory, so that God's Son may be glorified through it.' Now Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. So when he heard that Lazarus was sick, he stayed where he was for 2 more days. And then he said to his disciples, 'Let us go back to Judea.' 'But Rabbi,' they said, 'a short while ago, the Jews there tried to stone you, and yet you're going back?' Jesus answered, 'Are there not 12 hours of daylight? Anyone who walks in the daytime will not stumble, for they will see by his words light. It is when a person walks at night that they stumble, for they have no light.' And after he had said this, he went on to tell them, 'Our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep, but I am going there to wake him up.'" This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you very much, Mina and Cherono. You may have your seats. And we will move now into a time of reading the eulogy. And I'm going to invite our sisters, Cherop and Cheptum, to come up here to my right and read for us the eulogy.
Good morning, church. Good morning. Thank you for coming for this session. Looking fabulous, the way Chebet would have wanted it. I'm going to read the eulogy. My name is Chebet Toroitich Kwasi, and I was Chebet's older sister. The story of this day would not have been the first sign that this was not going to be an ordinary child. Born in Eldoret on 22nd June of 1987 to Dr. J.K. Toroitich and Mrs. Leah Toroitich, Chebet Kiboen Toroitich was a unique and caring individual who touched many lives. The only person that went to Alliance Girls High School and did not brag about it. In fact, she said she was in Brookhouse Kikuyu branch. A student of Aussie University, where she earned the right to travel to Perth, Australia, where she earned her degree in marketing. Known for the famous invitation line, "See you come," Chebet was always the life of the party. With her practical approach to life, and a mastery of being sophisticatedly simple. If Chebet called you, you'd expect to hear, "Uko?" Always the one with a plan, when asked where she was, she would say, "Niko humu humu," and she was always with a friend. "The Lord will provide," a phrase she picked up from her Christian upbringing at Nairobi Baptist Church. Chebet always had a positive view of life and faith that everything will always look out.
Good morning. My name is Cheptum, Chebet's youngest sister. Quick to call out any situation that made her uncomfortable with one of her popular lines, "Hi naka tu mashida." In fact, you mnaka mashida sai. Chebet always counted her blessings. She never understood why people complained about things they were going through and always threw in the line, "Sembuse mimi." And when things did not work out, she wouldn't wallow in the situation, but follow it with, "It is well." Niko kwa jam na kam. Chebet was always elegantly dressed and fashionably late. There was time and there was Chebet time. And if you questioned her for being late, she would say, "But see, I'm here." Chebet was an adventurous spirit with a love for travel and the finer things in life, a generous heart and kind to those around her. Pongezi, Chebet the cheerleader, always looking for her own colorful way to celebrate everyone's achievements. Besides, if you can't celebrate your friends, how can you celebrate yourself? She would probably be here looking at all your sad faces and tell you to stop looking like your problems. She refused to look like her problems. Even if you're broke, dress well, comb your hair, and smell nice, and always remain beautifully broke. Chebet did not believe in dwelling on issues for too long. And if you didn't know how to let go of something that bothered you, she would ask, "Are you still thinking about the past?" In classic Chebet nature, Chebet would end this conversation with her famous one-liners. "Why are you looking sad? Kwani ni matanga? Sitaki mashida. Nimewaacha na mashida zenu." Thank you.
Thank you very much, Cherop and Cheptum, for just sharing a bit about your sister's life. And we thank God just for the person that she was to many of us here. And just in line with that, we're going to move into a time of hearing a little bit more about our dear sister. And we're going to do this through tributes and speeches. We're going to begin with tributes from our dad and mom. And it's going to be read by Cheptum, who will represent her parents and their tributes.
I'm back. So I'm reading this tribute on behalf of my mother and my father, Dr. Toroitich, and my mom, Leah Toroitich. My parents, it's very difficult for them to stand up here, so I'll do it on their behalf. It is difficult to eulogize your own child because it's a parent's expectation that parents will die before their children. Chebet was a special child to us from the day she was born. She has always been calm and composed, but firm, since she was a baby. She grew up to be a very confident girl. Chebet has always been a go-getter and had an attribute of bringing people together, as you can see, and being very generous. Whenever we went to restaurants as a family, she always encouraged us, in particular her father, to tip the waiters very generously. Chebet never held any grudges. She would sometimes admonish us in a charitable way. Our lovely daughter had positive attributes, but also had some faults, like any other human person. Chebet, we love you and miss you so much, our baby. Rest in peace in heaven with the angels and the saints.
Thank you. And now we shall hear from the siblings. And the siblings shall be represented by Kiprotich, who will share on behalf of his brothers and sisters.
Morning, everybody. My name is Toroitich. Toroitich to most people, or Kip to some, and Toro to a few. Chebet's little brother. Tulikuwa tumefuatana. My sister Chebet, as you all know, was a kind soul, a generous person whose stay on earth was a net positive for all around her. Negativity was not her domain, just happiness, laughter, and selflessness. Spreading joy was her calling on this earth. An encounter with Chebet, whether you are a stranger or a close friend, would leave you smiling, guaranteed. I remember she would come into my friend's circle and immediately take over the conversation, and I thought I was fun. She was something else. I love you, dear sister, my fellow middle sibling. Words haven't been invented yet to describe the emptiness you have left, but I know you'll always be there with me, with us. Check in my dreams every once in a while. Until we meet again. Love her.
Thank you very much, Toroitich. We are now going to move into the uncles and aunties. And we have a representative of the uncles, Uncle Japheth, who will come up and share on behalf of the uncles. And then for the aunties, if we can have Mrs. Amy Cheboy coming up immediately after him to share. Karibuni.
Good morning, Church. Good morning once again. My name is Peter Kipchumba Cheserek. I am the uncle of Chebet. Mrs. Toroitich is my elder sister, and I've always been called uncle number one. It's been very unfortunate for us as a family, both from the father's side and the mother's side. We've taken it with a very heavy hearts. But I want to thank you so much for those who have come for this function. The last time we were with Chebet was on 26th of November, when we had a function for Cheptum. But to me, I've been telling my friends that that was a farewell party for Cheptum, for Chebet. Because Chebet was, I remember getting to their home, and she told me, Uncle, mbono umevaa jeans, you look like a thug. People are in suits, and we are walking here in the jeans. That is the nature of Chebet. Chebet is a lovely person with a very big heart. And unfortunately, there's nothing much we can say. For those of you who will be able to travel to Baringo Karibuni, I just want to introduce my younger brother. He's called Japheth Cheserek. And I don't know where the wife is. Eva, somewhere. She's in Chirono. The girl who has just talked here is the eldest daughter to my brother. Asante di sana, Pauline sana, Daktari, and Leah. We know, and you know, and we know the pain we've gone through. It was very unfortunate, for real, very, very unfortunate, because it's not easy for somebody to go to hospital and in less than 4 or 5 days, he's gone or she's gone. Asante di sana, Church.
Thank you. Mrs. Amy Cheboy. And after she shares her tribute, we will have another time of congregational singing, and we will sing Bwana Usehemu Yangu. So karibu to our auntie.
Praise the Lord, Church. Praise the Lord again. God is good. And all the time, let's at least smile for Chebet. You have heard her tribute. She was a girl who was very happy, very social. So let's not be sad. Because if we are sad, she will also feel like, why are people sad instead of celebrating me? You've heard my name is Emmy Chesire Cheboy. I stand here as an auntie. Dr. Toroitich is a sister to my sister, is a brother to my sister-in-law. And also, I'll bring condolences from Governor of Baringo. He's out of the country. And I want to say to Dr. and Mrs. Toroitich that is with you in prayers. We had this news on Monday evening, and he was traveling the same night. So it was really devastating as a family to all of us. It's not easy because this is a young soul, a young lady, an entrepreneur. As families, we are lost. Also as a county, we've actually lost somebody who was outgoing, somebody who was contributing positively to the county, a young person other people would look up to, and especially the young generation, because she did not wait to be employed, but she decided to employ herself. To the family, there's nothing much we can say. We can only say, may God in heaven be with you, because it is a time which you ask God so many questions. When such a time comes, you even ask God, why? Why? And we all ask, why? But as it is, God always picks the best. Chebet was one of the best among the best. She has gone to be with the Lord, but I would like to encourage the family with the word of God. In the book of Thessalonians, chapter 5, verse 18, where it tells us that we need to give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. When you step back and ask yourself, how do you give thanks in all circumstances? You start saying, thank you, God, for taking my daughter. But the Bible tells us that let's give thanks. God had a purpose and a reason why this had to happen, and to happen so suddenly. I'll finish with the word of God in the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verses 31, which says, those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They'll soar higher. They'll soar on wings like eagles. They'll run and not grow weary. They'll walk and not be faint. May that word encourage you as we move on to rest our dear girl. Let's remember that God is always with us. Let's continue talking and speaking about our girl. And on the day the trumpet calls, we should be ready to meet her on Jesus' feet. Thank you, and God bless you all. Asanteni.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Cheboy. I'd like to invite us to rise to our feet as we sing together that the Lord is our portion. The Lord is our strength. Bwana usehemu yangu. And that will be on the last page of your programs, the bottom half of your programs. You are our shield, O God. And we know, Father, that it is difficult, even in times of sorrow, to give thanks as we heard. But Lord, we give you thanks for the life of our sister and our daughter. We give you thanks that we got to experience the beauty of who she was. And so, Father, we ask that even in the midst of our tears, that you will walk with us on this journey of life, that you will comfort us, you will guide us, you will lead us, you will strengthen us, even for the season ahead. Pamoja na wewe. Pamoja ja na wewe. Pamoja.
Pamoja.
Trust in you, Lord, that one day at the end of it all, we will enter those pearly gates and we will see our loved ones again. In Jesus' name, we believe and pray. Amen. I'll invite us to take our seats as we continue to hear these beautiful tributes of our late sister. And I'm going to invite a representative of her friends, Wayua, are you here? Yes, Wayua, please come up. And then after Wayua, we will have Rims. So Rims, if you can also come up onto the stage if you're around. Rims. Karibuni.
Praise God, church. Good morning. Chebet, flying with the angels. To my love, Chebet, the good Lord has called you to be part of his kingdom. Part of my heart is sad and broken, but the other part of my heart is full of happiness and content as you are now with your best people, Whitney Houston and Michael Jackson. As your best friend forever, I will miss you the way you brought joy and happiness into my world. I will miss how you were always ready and able to hang out with me and go on trips with random people you didn't know. I know you will be watching me, you will be watching over me as I have one glass of wine. Until we meet again, much love, your best friend forever, where you are. I will now read Nkatha and Angie's tribute. Chebet, where do we start? The love, the laughter, the moments, the life we have lived together, more than a friend, closer than a siblings. We can't put what we feel in this one paragraph. It's been a lifetime of love. Throughout the years, we have known and learned that you are always there to listen wholeheartedly without judging and allowing us to feel comfortable coming to you with anything under the sun. Whoa. Your style was impeccable. I hear you always telling me, Katha, dude, your nails, yo. Thanks for putting me on check. Chebet, Chebet, Chebet. It's me, Shiko. It's been difficult. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to feel. I miss you so much already. I hear you telling me, always look for me. What are we going to do now? I was saying, mate, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. You will always be forever young in our hearts. Go on, mate. We will always love you, Nkatha and Angie Shiko. I will now read Winnie Towet's tribute. My Chebet, rest well, my love. This is the most painful thing I have ever had to do in my life. You have a special place in my heart till we meet again. Good morning, church. Praise the Lord. I will start with Nyawira's tribute. Chebet, I can still hear your heartfelt laughter in my head. You had so much to live for. All these plans we made to travel and experience the world together. You are always a delight to be around. Your sense of humor, good taste in music, and above everything, your view on life that was wise beyond your years. You embodied everything love, friendship, and beauty is. Keep smiling, Chebet, forever in my heart. Nyawira. And then I will read now Chapter Obore. Chebet, I don't know where to start. 26 years of always knowing you are there means a world without you in it doesn't make sense. 1996 at the Riara primary entrance interview is where this friendship that ended up engulfing our families and those close to us began. It was a lifetime of friendship and sisterhood that started from when we met. Cherop, your ever-present sister, can attest. Our first act was to try and circumvent the entrance exam, and we failed miserably at that. From then on, there was no stopping us. From constants on the noisemakers list, even when absent, to avoiding cross-country, even though you could really run, not forgetting crashing birthday parties we weren't invited to, and having the most fun at them. From high school shenanigans to navigating life as young adults with freshly minted degrees, you are always there. At every major milestone, you are a constant and always fabulous doing it. We definitely can't forget your bridesmaid's dress at my wedding with a train as long as, if not longer, than mine. I won't go down the rabbit hole of our endless stories and history, but ours was certainly a special bond that went through ups and downs to the very pits, but we always found our way to each other. Chebet, you are not only a friend to me, but to so many. A social butterfly is what you are. And in many groups, you are the one that held all the various personalities together while still maintaining a deep and meaningful individual friendship with all. You had an air about you that drew people to you and a big bright smile for everyone you met. I will forever be grateful that I had a chance to see you one last time when you got admitted, and even then, you were cracking your usual jokes and calling me names as you always have while keeping a brave face despite the pain I knew you were in. I didn't know that was goodbye, but I remain comforted knowing memories of you live forever. You are and will always be sorely missed. Your friend, Chebet Obore. And finally, I will read my own. The cheerfulness of Chebet could make heavy burdens, no matter the cause, all disappear in a moment. My sister friend, these last 17 years have been such a great ride with you by my side. I knew you wouldn't do wrinkles. Life was so much easier and fun with you around. You lived a full and colorful life, always ready for the next chapter. I love you, Chebet. Your hearty laugh must light up heaven. Niko kwa jam na kam, forever and ever in my heart. Wairimo.
Thank you very much for sharing those beautiful tributes. Our final tribute this morning will come from a neighbor. And I'd like to invite the retired Justice Maraga to please come up on the invitation of the family to share a tribute.
Good morning, church. Thank you for this opportunity to mourn a young girl whom we all considered as our daughter. We live in Karen, in a gated community of 10 homes. And our children have grown together like like one family, really. We moved into that gated community in 1997, early. And Chebet's parents joined us soon thereafter. We've been together all those years. Chebet has grown up with our children, as she did with the children of other neighbors. For me, it is very painful because this is a girl I used to meet, especially when I took my morning walk. Chebet would meet me. As I'm walking, I see a smile and say, "Good morning, uncle." Have one or two words and then say, "Have a lovely day." That is the girl we have all lost. We are sad that she has left. My friend, Dr. Toroitich, Leah, Chiptum, and your other siblings, we condole with you and wish that God will condole with you even more than ourselves. Apostle Paul was faced with a situation like this with the new converts in the Thessalonian church who believed that the Lord was going to come during their lifetime. But when he did not, and friends and relatives were dying, they thought that was their end. So Paul, in 1 Thessalonians 4, from verse 13, consoling them, says, "Do not mourn like ignorant people. Do not mourn like people without a hope." As we mourn Chebet, my friend Dr. Toroitich, and your family, let us mourn with that blessed hope that Christ is coming and coming very soon, and they will resurrect his to eternal kingdom. We are with you, we mourn with you. May God give you the comfort no human being can give you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Justice Maraga. I'm going to invite Tony Mwanda, who will be sharing a song this morning, to please come up. Tony, are you here? Okay, and as Tony comes up, just a reminder of where the bathrooms are. So for those who may need to use the restrooms, you can either take this lift at exit one or use the stairs and go downstairs all the way to the reception and then go round this way to the back of the sanctuary. There you'll find the ladies and the gents. Karibu sana, Tony.
Afternoon. I'm sure it's feeling very strange seeing me this instrument here. when I met Chebet, I was going through some stuff about 5 years ago, and three things really kept me in place. My three kids, Chebet, and my music, because I started studying music when I met her, and she always used to encourage me. So she always tell me, "You should perform." I tell her, "No, no. My music is for me and my own personal space." So she told me next year I had to perform in front of people and with her. And this has happened. So I felt, let me just do this, and hopefully I won't embarrass myself. But let me just play one song for her as we bid her goodbye. So I'll play a song, Abide By Me, which I think is a prayer for God to stay with us in death as he did with us in life. And thanks.
Amen. Let's give him another clap for having the courage just to share his music for the first time in front of a congregation. And just the words of that hymn, Abide With Me. And even as we go into a new season of not having our dear sister with us, may the Lord abide with us. May he walk with us through the journey ahead. I'm going to invite us to sing a song just before we go into our sermon, Great is Thy Faithfulness. And so I'm going to invite us to rise to our feet, and immediately after this, we will have Reverend Munengi Mulandi, who will be sharing the word of God with us this morning. So Great is Thy Faithfulness. It should also be on page 9 of your programs. The bottom half of the program. Great is thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
Strength for today and hope for tomorrow, and for that we are thankful, in Jesus' name. Kindly do sit. I really want to congratulate you for taking time to come and be with this family. Family, I hope you don't mind if I ask you, just look at the multitude of people who have left their weekday activities to come to be with you. I know perhaps not each one of us will have a chance to shake your hand or to let you know that we are here. But it's just a blessing to see such a sea of humanity and love. Let's just thank God for that. I am really happy to see each one of you. Like you've heard, my name is Munengi Mulandi. I serve here with a team that has been here. And in some time, we are going to take an offering. Our culture here at Nairobi Baptist Church is that we receive an offering at a service like this to give back to the families in its entirety. And so all the offering that we'll collect today will be given 100% to the family, because it is your opportunity. Perhaps you are not able to visit at the home or any of the evening meetings that they had, and you just want to give a token of love towards those days that our dear sister was in hospital, or the journey of planning this funeral and the logistics for the burial. And so we will have some time to receive an offering. Our ushers, who are family members and friends, will receive the offering. They will count it, and then they will pass it back to the family. So please do plan to give generously. Those of you who prefer an M-Pesa way of giving, there will be that opportunity. So kindly do prepare for that. Let me once again say, because we do quite a number of funerals here in this sanctuary, that we have not seen it this full for a service. Thank you very much for coming. But let me also add a sad note that when we are this many, we also tend to attract a few persons who come for personal gain at your expense, at my expense. And so, ladies, watch out for your handbags. If you don't mind just holding your purse in a way that you can relax and not worry about it. And gentlemen, they also begin sending SMS messages. I don't know how they know the numbers to tell you that your car, you know, needs attention or things like that. Please be careful. We are living in Nairobi for now. But I think we are continuing to reform the city to the glory of God. The Honorable Chief Justice Emeritus and your good wife, we are very, very happy to see you here. I didn't know you're a neighbor, and so I had prepared my remarks about you before you came. I didn't know that you are going to be invited. But this is a good man, is he not? We thank God for you and the way you have served this nation. We didn't even know that you have such an intimate relationship with the family. So thank you for coming. In this church, we have one of our young people who has named his son, just a six-year-old boy, who is called Maraga after you, because he said, that's a man of integrity. And I want my son to be asking, why am I called this name? And none of our relatives are called by this name. It is because of the legacy that the Lord gave you. We happen to know, we have done our investigation, you happen to be a faithful of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, and so you worship on Saturdays, which means you're free every Sunday to join us here at Nairobi Baptist Church, and a warm welcome to you and your family. I also wanted to recognize others who are among us. Is it okay if I ask you to just appreciate our worship team that were leading us in song? This is because we do not have a paid choir or a weekday choir. They're just volunteers who have come out from their normal activities, including retirement and including our mom there from recuperation. She had an accident and said, I want to rush to the house of mourning and be a blessing to them. Bwana sifiwe. We also want to appreciate several people who have made time to be here. Madam, the First Lady of Baringo, thank you for coming. You know this is home for you and your good husband, His Excellency Bwana Chiboy, and thank you for bringing his greetings. I just wanted to send you with a message that this wonderful land of Baringo, I have not been invited to, and so this is my opportunity to ask for an official invitation. I was only there when I was a staff with World Vision, and then, you know, I was traveling up and down working. Now I want to come to see what God has done by this, our second term, Governor, and we thank God for you. I'm sorry, despite my young age, I can't see all the other honorables who are here. Is it okay if I just say generally we thank God for you and all the decorations, social and economic, that the Lord has given you, that you come with today to comfort this family. I'm joined by Reverend Ezekiel Kimosop from the Africa Inland Church, Milimani, and he will be coming. He's a member of the family, but he's a clergyman, so we asked him to sit with us. He'll be sharing a little later in the program. Let's appreciate him, tafadhali. May I ask you to stand so that we can thank God for you, Reverend Kimosop. Thank you, and God bless you. Do we have other clergy who are seated here? You're a clergy person, not with Nairobi Baptist Church. I'm sorry, we perhaps didn't recognize you in that role. Please stand and remain standing. Okay, but we do have Pastor Melina, who is leading us here, the service. We have Pastor Kezia and Pastor Leah Bulemi. We thank God for you. Pastor Ken, also, who has been coordinating us, Pastor Ken Ochola. We thank God for you. I'm going to be speaking about friends, and that's why I'm being a little liberal in introducing different friends who have come and been with us. We have some who are non-pastoral, who are at the back, Mr. Juice Remington, Mr. Ketch, Bwana Moses Nganga. We thank God for you who are minding our sound and media to be able to communicate well. I was very surprised as I came in. I know the family, but I didn't know we're that close until when I saw my sister is here, and she told me she's even an usher. This is how family meetings happen in our place, because everybody's so busy. We meet at meetings like this, formerly known as Cherono Towet, now Cherono Mulandi. Please, we want to appreciate you for coming. That is my elder brother's wife. Daktari, I hear the Wakambas have been raiding your home in a larger extent and now narrowing in. The Lord bless you. I want to share briefly the words that the Lord laid on my heart from the passage that was very well read to us, and a very common passage in times like this. This is where we get the famous John 11:35, the shortest verse in the Bible, Jesus wept. But I really want to narrow on one statement that Jesus makes. Jesus is up and about in Bethany with his disciples. He gets this rather urgent SMS message. And as he's reading it, the disciples are wondering, what message is this that has come? Because it must have shown in a facial reaction or in some way that they wanted to know a little more about what had happened. What does the message say? And then he tells them, you know, Martha and Mary, you know them. They have lost their brother, Lazarus. But I like the way Jesus puts it. Our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep. Our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep. For those of you who are very familiar with the scriptures, you know what happens. After 2 days or so, Jesus goes to the home. Before he gets to the home, one sister after another come to him and say, you know, if only you had been here, things would not have ended up as they are. And Jesus speaks to them words of comfort. And they say, yeah, we believe, but if only you had been here. And then Jesus goes to the opening of the tomb and he says, Lazarus, come forth. And they begin to be concerned that it's been 4 days. this is not the time to open, you know, the tomb of where he has been laid. But Jesus, in a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. The story is a little longer than we have time for. Lazarus comes out, tied in all these burial clothes, and Jesus asks that he is set loose of them and restores Lazarus to this family. I want to share, like I've said, about friends. Think about your close 3-4 friends. If you do have a spouse, include them in those 3-4 friends. And just think of the wonderful things they've done to you, for you, in the last week or so. Some of you are frequent flyers, and so you might need 2 weeks. Okay, 2 weeks. Something that's pleasant. Some of you just thinking about it, you're just smiling at the thought of what they did for you recently. You see, there are two aspects about a friend. Is that they know you so well that they know what to give you. And then they love you so much that they go to great extents to offer it. They know you so well that they know what to give to you. They love you so much that they go to great extents to offer it. But you see, friends are human. They have some limitation in knowing you so well. They have some limitation in loving you so much. And so every so often, they might be a little off in what they offer because they don't know you perfectly. They might be a little off because although they love you, they are unable to go to great extents due to their human limitation. I have been desiring a new car, like every young gentleman of my age would like. Unfortunately, my wife is very insensitive or inert to that desire. But I am also desirous to build a house and for us to move into this house as a family. And the amazing thing is that my wife is very sensitive to that one. The other day, we passed by the place where we want to buy and build this magnificent 2-bedroom house. And it's amazing how moved she is emotionally just when she sees the grass on that piece of 40 by 80. And the amazing thing is that she looks at the grass with her glance going upwards because she's imagining, you know, balconies overlooking the gardens, etc., ad infinitum, ad nauseam. But the amazing thing, although she loves me so much, it is beyond her means to say, if you allow me to use the Kikuyu language, Reke Marie. She just can't walk into a bank, at least currently, and say, give my husband this, and a house will come up. She's not the only friend that is limited. Just last night, we had a prayer service across in our smaller sanctuary, and one of the pastors very close to me saw me just lingering around after the prayer service, and, you know, took a cup and said, Pastor, kunywa chai. This is somebody I know who loves me very much, who knows me very well. But they have no idea, despite our working together for not less than 6 or 7 years, that I'm allergic to milk. My allergy sometimes is so heightened that even proximity to somebody taking tea gives me serious nausea. And so I was not just lingering around aimlessly. I was trying to be with the people, but with those who had finished their tea because just the smell of milk. By the way, those of you looking at me with pity, this is one of the greatest gifts that I have, not being able to take milk. And it, somehow it runs in the family, in my mother's house, in my wife's house. None of us take milk. And so by 7 a.m., we have milked all the cows and we have sold all the milk. This is a very profitable allergy. But you see, this friend of mine who knew me, who knows me, has limitations to how well they know me, to know the nitty-gritties of my social life, that I don't go near people when they're taking tea because it could be disastrous when the allergy is very heightened. My wife, who knows me very well, knows, you know, the kind of things that I want, loves me very much, but yet is restricted, is limited, that she just can't say, Reke Maria, that house, and it happens. And so it bothers me when we look at Scripture and Jesus says, our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep. Lazarus is not just a friend of a friend. Lazarus is not just a friend of this lady who, you know, many demons were relieved of, you know, Martha and Mary, you know, who are friends. No, he's not only the sister of, I mean, the friend, the brother of a sister. No. He himself, by Jesus' own confession, was a friend. In fact, so much so that when John 11:35 is happening, Jesus wept. People around the crowd say, look how he loved him. But how come? How come? How come? This friend who knew Lazarus so well and his sisters, that he knew exactly what they needed and he knew what to give them. We are going into the Christmas season and many of us are going to be very disappointed because we are going to get gifts that are very absurd. I think the people who suffer the most are men. This might be inappropriate in terms of gender sensitivities, but I don't think our society has learned what gifts to give men. Anniversary, birthday, Christmas is always socks, a diary. You know, you get a gift and you realize this person is true, they might love me, but they don't know me to know what my needs are. I don't know if you've ever gotten a gift from a friend and you are like, this is exactly what I was thinking of. And you had not tangazad like me to my wife, my two desires. They just know you so well that they know what to give and package it. By the time you open it up, you say, this is exactly, and you feel that cord of friendship. Jesus, a friend of Lazarus, a friend to the two sisters and their family, knew them so well that he knew what to give them. But here lies Lazarus. And here are the two sisters, inconsolable. And yet Jesus says, our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep. Jesus, a true friend, loved them so much and would go to great extents and had the capability. Unlike the limitations of my wife, Jesus had no limitations. The Son of God, Emmanuel, God with us, King of kings and Lord of lords, born a king, not coronated to be king. King Mtarajiwa, when the senior royals die, then he can become king. No, born a king. And yet, friend who loved so much but didn't deliver in their sorrow. Lazarus in a tomb, the two sisters inconsolable. You see, if you don't know the rest of the Bible, then that might be your conclusion. You see, Jesus was a true friend, knew them so well, and knew exactly what to give them, loved them so much that he went to great extents to offer it. Because although he raises Lazarus, Lazarus, come forth, he's brought to life. But I don't know any of you have been walking on Muindimbingo Street if you've seen Lazarus around there. I don't know those of you who live just along that highway to Carbonell if you've seen Lazarus running a boda boda business around there. You see, Lazarus was raised from the dead, but he died again. And Jesus, knowing the sorrow of the sisters and what the family were going through, raises him from the dead. But that was only short term. A few short and quick chapters after that, he goes to the cross and says, "It is finished," and dies for that Lazarus, that when he would die again, that it would have no mastery over him, because his sins, my sins, and your sins had been paid for. By a true friend who knows what we really need, not just what we want. I mean, let's be honest. If my wife does this car and house combination 40 years from now, what will they mean to me? The car will have gone. The house will now be complaining, such a big house. I talk, then I hear myself talking again, again, again. The echoes of an emptiness. You see, it's important for me now. It's all I can see now, this house and this car. But you know, that was important enough for Jesus to raise Lazarus. But even more important for himself, Jesus Christ, to rise from the dead, that Lazarus would never need to die again. That the crying sisters would never need to cry again. Because Jesus did not do a half job. Jesus hung on the cross and said, "It is finished," and resurrected after being buried. An empty tomb, the songwriter says, is proof that Jesus rose from the dead. And so I present to you a friend who knows so well that he knows what to give. But a friend who loves so much that he goes to great extents to offer it. In the New Testament, I find an interesting verse. Jesus, speaking to the people, says, "When your son asks for bread, do you give him a stone?" And they say, "Obviously not." And then he tells them, "Evil as you are, you know how to give good gifts to your children. How much more me as God? How much more me as God?" And so, parents of our sister Chebet, siblings, family members, loved ones, near and far, this feels like a time when God is far. When we can ask, when we would ask what Martha and Mary asked, when we would state, "If only you had been here. You know, Lord, she was in hospital, did our uncle say, 3-4 days or so? That would have been a good time for you to visit." We may not understand it all. We may not have all the answers to our questions. But we have one we can trust, because he knows us well enough to know what to give and loves us richly enough to go to great extents to offer it. What we have been offered today on a beautiful silver platter is a stone.
But because we know our God, we look at it and with all our limited faculties, it is a stone. We look at it, we feel it, it's a stone. It's hard grief for such a young person. Anybody who dies who's younger than me is really, really young. Think of all the dreams. Think of all the her gifts now being exploited well into her 50s and 60s. Just think about this. What we have before us is a stone. But we must choose to trust God and hold it until it turns into bread. Because he has promised. The story I like, our late dad was a fast driver. I say this because he lived in the years before NTSA. And every Friday, he would pick me from school, a boarding school just down the road, and would take me home. We live on the longer section of Mombasa Road. And dad would be driving so fast. Now, I knew my dad very well. He was a good swimmer. I was also a good swimmer. I had competed in several races by this time. I was 9. But in front of us was a huge lake. And my father is not slowing down as we are driving straight to drown. And here I was, you know, tapping on his knee. Daddy, we are going to drown. We are good swimmers, but we're going to drown. That it looks like such a huge sea. Daddy, we're going to drown. And Daddy would keep driving at the same speed. And I would say my prayers. But I also pray for him, knowing that he's not going to heaven because he drove us into our death. That was my theology at that time. And then he'd just drive over a lake. You know, it wasn't until I went to high school and studied some optics in physics that I realized that is a mirage. It's an optical illusion. All your faculties register that it's a lake. But as you get closer, it's no lake. It's an optical illusion. And so, Father, we come before you this afternoon with sorrow and sadness, grief so deep, it feels like we have been served a stone on a silver platter. But it's a spiritual illusion. We trust in you. We don't know how you make heads and tails of this, but we trust you. You who knit her in mama's womb, you who brought us her to us, a little girl. You who allowed us to follow her in her fantasies and her desires. This does not smell like bread. But because we trust you, we'll hold this plate. We'll move to cabinet. We'll lay her body there, her remains, and lower them to the ground. But hold this plate with what all our faculties registers as a stone. But we are just waiting on you. Because you said it is finished. And one day, it will smell like fresh bread. And one day, just like the Lazarus sisters, we'll be able to say, you are the resurrection and the life. One day, we'll look at this and feel the softness of freshly baked bread because Jesus, you are on the throne. And so, Lord, until faith becomes sight, give strength to Daddy, give strength to Mommy. Give strength to these siblings, these loved ones, both near and far, row after row and across the camera. Lord, this is when we sing, Nishike mkono Bwana, Niongoze, because we need you. And so our Father and our God, we trust in you. Like the psalmist says, allow us not to be ashamed, and let not our enemies, even death, triumph over us. Lord, could it be that there are one or two or several who have come for this service, who have been living life avant-garde, and so are unable to appreciate how we can have a plate with our stone and even bacon for salt and ketchup, some butter and marmalade, quickly. For the Lord has called it bread, and so it shall become. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Join us in this song that says Nishikilie.
Nishikilie, niongoze, bali na waovu, babae, nionyeshe njia zako. Tazifuata milele.
Nishikilie,
nishikilie, niongoze mbali na waovu, babae,
nionyeshe
njia zako, nami nitazifuata.
Lord, would you continue to hold us? Would you continue to walk with us as we have that hope in your resurrection, the finished work of the cross? In Jesus' name we believe and pray. Amen. Amen. We are going to now take an offering, and I'm going to invite our ushers. Our ushers, are you ready? So we're going to take an offering this morning for the family. And just as we do that, I would like to recognize the presence of one of our PSS, Jonathan Mweke, who's here with us. I'm not sure exactly where he's sitting. Thank you very much. So just wanted to recognize his presence. The ushers will be passing around the offering bags. And as they do that, the team is going to sing a song for us this morning, and then we shall pray for the family. And the song that we are going to sing this morning was actually requested by my mom, who is sitting there at the back, and she is one of Dr. Toroitich's patients. And one of the things she said is when she was in the isolation ward, when she was unwell, Dr. Toroitich was one of the doctors, one of the only doctors who consistently came to see her despite the risk that there was to his life. He was a comfort to her. And so we pray that even this morning that we can also be a comfort to you as we sing this song, reminding ourselves that in Christ, he is our comfort.
When I am down, and oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burden me, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit awhile with me. Strong when I am one.
this hunger, each restless heart beats so imperfectly. But when you come, I am filled with wonder. Sometimes I feel I glimpse eternity.
So, Lord, we pray that even these gifts and offerings that have been given will be a blessing to this family. A reminder that you have surrounded them with people that will walk this journey with them. We thank you and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, we believe and pray.
Amen.
Amen. For those who may not have seen the M-Pesa pay bill, is on our screen. And so if you wanted to give electronically, you can do that through the pay bill number 804-8277, and the account number will just be your name. I'll invite the ushers to come into the vestry once you have done the collection. Karibuni. Okay. And we are now going to take some time just to pray for our family. And so I'm going to invite the family members to please join us up here on stage so that we can just have a time of prayer for the family. And I invite Reverend Mulandi and as well as Reverend Kimosop from AIC to join us here. And perhaps we have a few more clergy that may be friends of the family that are in the congregation. I also invite you to join us as we pray for the family. Nishike mkono Bwana, nishike mkono, nishike mkono Bwana, nishike mkono, nishike mkono,
nishike mkono Bwana,
nishike
Nishike mkono Bwana,
Margoria family here. Thank you for coming to stand with these dear ones, the Boers as well. Let's commit them to the Lord who is able to keep them. Congregation, if it is okay, I'm going to ask you to stand, and if you are comfortable, if you are able to stand, do stand, if you are able. But also as a sign of faith, if it is possible, just to stretch your hand in faith towards them and just say something to the Lord as they begin a very new journey. Just go ahead and just, in the language that you know, just ask God's blessings on them. Just ask God to be with them. After all, isn't this the period of time that we say, God Emmanuel, God with us? Let's ask that he visits with them in a very special way.
Hakuna wa kufanana na Yesu.
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 Hakuna wa kufanana na Yesu. Hakuna wa kufanana na Yesu.
Hakuna wa kufanana na Yesu.
Hakuna wa kufanana na Yesu.
Hakuna wa kufanana na Yesu.
Hakuna wa kufanana na Yesu.
Ni muweza.
Ni muweza.
Our Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we are before you this particular afternoon, Jehovah. We want to thank you for the Father that you have come with us. Here before us, dear Father, we have heard your voice, and you have spoken to us about Lazarus and the love of God. And we are touched by that message. It has given us inspiration to know that, God, you have a purpose for our lives. We are here, Lord God Almighty, we have the family standing here in front of this sanctuary, and we want to commend this family to you, Jehovah, that you shall walk with them, King of Glory, and strengthen this family. And Lord Almighty God, in every situation and circumstance that they go through, Lord God, may you walk with them, Jehovah. May the comforts of God that never fail to Lazarus, even at the lowest moment, will come for this family, Jehovah. May you meet them at the point of every need. May you protect and provide for them. May the presence of God continually dwell with them. And may your word be a center of authority for their lives, King of Glory. We want to commend them to you now, even concerning issues that are ahead of them, dear Father. We pray that the grace of God continues to abide. Even now, Jehovah God, we want to thank you and we want to honor you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And we all say, amen.
Yeni muweza, yeni muweza, hakuna wa kufanana na ye.
Oh, yeah. Kimbilio,
yeah, kimbilio,
kimbilio,
yeah, kimbilio.
hakuna wakufanana naye. Name we believe and pray. Amen. Amen. I'd like us to take our seats this afternoon as we just move into the last stages of our service, and we're going to move into the announcements, and our representative of the family is Mr. Kiprop, who will come and give us the announcements of where to from here. After him, we'll go into our vote of thanks, which will be done by our Reverend Kimosop that prayed for us earlier on. Karibu sana.
Good afternoon. Praise God, church. Before I say a few things, I'd like to ask by show of hands. Pastor Mulandi, you're there, right? How many of you went to Alliance? By show of hands. Pastor Mulandi, these people need a special prayer of repentance. Chebet understood the beatitude that says, blessed are the humble, for they shall inherit the earth. So if you raised your hand, you need a confession. Demusitu sumbue kwa hii town. Over this period, we've all thought, cried, asked questions. And I remembered the words of Mary Ann Baker, who wrote the story on the hymn, Master, the Tempest is Raging. And she wrote, the billows are tossing high. The sky is overshadowed with blackness. There's no shelter or help that's nigh. She then asks, carest not that we perish? How can you lie asleep when each moment so sadly is threatening, a grave in the angry deep rip? Then she says, The wind and the waves shall obey thy will. Peace be still. Whether the wrath of the storm-tossed sea, or demons, or men, or whatever it be, no waters can swallow the ship where lies the master of the ocean and earth and sky. In verse 3, she says, Master, the terror is over when all had calmed. The elements sweetly rest. Earth's sun in the calm lake is mirrored, and heaven's within my breast. Linger, O blessed Redeemer, leave me alone no more, and with joy I shall make the blessed harbor and rest on the blissful shore. Then they all refrain, they all shall sweetly obey thy will. Peace be still, peace be still. They all shall sweetly obey thy will. Peace, peace be still. And that's my prayer to the family and all of us. On the notices, anyone who hasn't consoled with the family, or you feel you'd like to come again, we shall be home today from the afternoon, maybe 4 or 5 o'clock, and we shall have the last prayers, so you can pass by home. On Monday, the body shall depart Lee at 6:30 a.m. to Wilson Airport, and so those who are in Nairobi, and would like to say their final byes, and they will not be coming home, please, you can come to Lee, and then you can see us off to Wilson Airport. We shall be laying Chebet to rest at a beautiful village. This being a long weekend, I would ask all of you, if you can, to come to Kabarbet. You know the story of Baringo Serikali's idea. There is a place in Baringo that's more beautiful and greener than Kiambu. Please make time if you can. It's 15 kilometers from Kabarnet Town towards Kabatonjo. We will share the map. Those who will be in Kabarnet can meet us at the airstrip at 8:45 to welcome and escort her home. Our little town has limited accommodation, but some are available. We were actually notified that one of the UN bodies has taken most of the hotels. So we would be advising, if you'd like to stay close by, there is a hotel in Koriema where you know the beautiful meat. There is Lake Bogoria. Nakuru and Eldoret are just 2 hours drive. So if you stay there, if you leave at 7:30, you'll be home at 9:30. At the end of the service, the family shall exit through this exit, and they'll be seated right behind there, and the rest of us can use the side exit, and we can go and say pole to them. We have some pole from Joshua Chepkoin, Joshua Kulei, John Tanui, David Koros, Engineer Kandie, DL, Honorable Cheptumo, and Justice Lenaola. If you don't get to see them, they've sent their pole. Finally, I want to thank all of you, each and every person. When this journey started, we didn't know what to do. You've made the impossible to be possible. You are all amazing people. There is no one like you. On behalf of my nephew, Dr. Toroitich, and my mother, Leah, how they got married, I don't know, and my cousins, we are so thankful and humble. I can say this without fear of contradiction. Always count on us. Always count on us. Daktari, I know how hard it is to thank you. There are many people here who would have really loved to thank you in their journey of life. I am one of them. When I didn't know what to do, I know the one time that you took an action that saved my life. And so there are many of such people here. This was our little way to say thank you. And so we want to say pole, but we want to thank you for the many things you've done for many. If everyone was to stand here, you would not get to the end of it. So just accept our thank you, and may God bless you. Thank you, and I welcome the church. Asante.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kiprop. I would like to invite Reverend Kimosop, who will do our vote of thanks.
Bwana asifiwe. Praise the Lord. Allow me to do the vote of thanks. But before I do that, just to say that as you have been told, my name is Ezekiel Kimosop. I'm a pastor with AIC Milimani, previously serving with AIC Wilson Airport. And I also serve with Pioneer Community Church Eldoret. I would like to say again pole to Daktari and family, and to give my words of pole also from my wife, who could not be able to join us today. She asked me to pass her condolences. Allow me then to proceed to give the vote of thanks. Something else I left out, of course, I didn't say that, and this is important to say, that I'm a maternal cousin to Leah. And my mother and her mother are actually cousins. Now, on the Thanksgiving, allow me to thank the following category of people for their instrumental support to the family during this difficult period. I know that we may not mention all the names, but we will mention out some people here and there. And if your name is not heard, please know that we appreciate the contribution that you have made. First is to wish to appreciate the doctors who did their best professionally to save our daughter at Nairobi Ice Hospital ICU. They did a great job. But as we know it, that the Lord had the final say on this, and the Lord rested her. So we want to appreciate them for the work they did. Also to thank relatives, friends, professional colleagues, and neighbors of the Toroitich family who have stood with the family right from the day that the sad news broke out. People gathered in their home to come and mourn with them. And I would like specifically to mention and single out, among others, our retired Chief Justice, Honorable Maraga. He stood together with the neighbors and they comforted that family and have been a source of strength all through up to this particular moment and going forward. We also want to thank Martin Mulwa, specifically again as a special mention, for the contribution he made in comforting this family and the tasks that he played. I'd like to thank the funeral committee led by Kiprop Chirchir, who came just before me here. He has coordinated us in terms of logistical meetings and guiding us in these programs and processes. We want to appreciate all of them and to thank them for their tireless efforts, which continue to be ahead of us, and to appreciate all that they have done and will continue to do. Allow me also to appreciate and to thank every person who has made financial contribution to this funeral program. There are people who have given their money and continuing to give. We are collecting money to support the medical bill expenses together with the funeral, which will be there next Monday. We want to appreciate all of you, including even those that have given the offering, which will go to the family. We want to appreciate all that. It's a gesture of support and love for this family. Allow me also to thank and to appreciate Reverend Mulandi, together with the entire pastoral team of Nairobi Baptist Church, for their accepting to host this function or event today. We want to appreciate your support and the encouragements and all the logistics that have gone towards hosting this meeting today here, and also the message that has comforted our souls. Thank you very much, and may the Lord bless you for that. And we wish finally to appreciate every person or every other person who in one way or another supported the family, and therefore we want to say thank you and may the Lord bless you. And finally, we'd like to thank every person who found time to attend this funeral service. All of you that have come today, we want to say thank you and may the Lord bless you for coming to stand with the family at a time like this. May God bless you. And allow me to rest there and say, the Lord bless you and the Lord keep you. If you're able to join us, like Kiprop said, please come and join us on Monday so that we can be able to send our daughter to rest. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you. Let's appreciate the Reverend Ezekiel Kimoson. He is a family member, but also part of the clergy. And now I'm going to ask him, together with the other clergy led by Pastor Melina, if you could please come to the floor. I'm going to ask the worship team to please take your position to lead us in some singing as I give instructions as to how we'd like to leave. Now, I appreciate we are quite a number, but we've requested that we do not use exit 1, 2, or 3. We will not use exit 1, 2, or 3. Those are all the ones on my left. We have locked them. They're not open for our use at this time. We are going to lead the family through exit number 5 shortly, and we're going to seat them at the back there, such that if you would like to just shake their hand and say, Paule, you'll use exit 4, and then move left to right and say Paule to them as you exit that way. However, should you be a little pressed and perhaps you'll meet them at Lee Funeral Home on Monday, or perhaps at home in Cabinet later on Monday, then when you exit through number 4, you're welcome to take a left and to go to your transport. Exit number 6, number 7, number 8 will be open, and you're welcome to also go out that way. There are stairs that can take you down that way. However, if you want to just shake the hand of the family, kindly restrict yourself to exit number 4 so that we don't have people running into each other at the back. So if you are going to say Paula to the family, you only have exit number 4. That way you can be able to say Paula to them moving from my left to right. If you need to dash because of just the nature of Friday afternoon, please feel free to use exit 4 and then turn left or exit number 6, number 7, or number 8 and use the stairs and or if you prefer to use the ramp and go that way. I'm going to ask that we stand for the benediction as we leave. However, if you don't mind, I'll ask that we request that we give the family just about a minute or so to get to the back before we are ready to greet them. Is that okay? And now to him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us before his glorious throne, blameless and with exceeding joy, to you, O Lord, be glory, dominion, and honor, now and forevermore. Amen. The Lord bless you and your loved ones both near and far. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you for coming to be with Daktari and Mama and their children and their loved ones. Thank you so much for coming to visit Nairobi Baptist Church. We are honored that you came to visit us. You're welcome to visit us any other time, and so that we can fellowship together in the Lord. Thank you. Worship team, please kindly go ahead.
Bwana ni mchungaji wangu, sitapungukiwa kitu, hulaza kwenye majani mabichi, huniongoza kwa maji matulivu, hunihuisha nafsi yangu, huniongoza kwa njia za haki, nipitapo bondeni.
You are welcome to exit now. 4, 6, 7, 8.
Nyumbani mwa Bwana.
maisha yangu. Hakika
number two and number three, if you're going down. If you are going down, number two and number three are now open for you. However, if you want to greet the family, keep it to number four. We have opened number two, number three, number six, seven, and eight. If you are leaving the compound, number four, if you're greeting the family.